Shalom from Israel. We are in the Negev, in the desert of Israel, right by the border with Egypt. I came all the way to border of Egypt because the Egypt, it was the place when people of Israel come out and celebrated Pesach, Passover. The Hebrew name for it, Pesach or Passover. And when we're going to study this year about Passover, we're going to study about God's miracle, God's supernatural power. And name of the feast is Passover or Pesach, the angel of death. Passover or Pesach over the houses of Israelis, because at that night, people of Israel make the covenant with God. By His direction, He gave them exact directions what to do, family by family, tribe by tribe, and they did it. And because of that, when death came to Egypt, angel of death came to Egypt, but God's glory and God's power, angels of protection were over people of Israel. So when we celebrate Passover, first of all, another name for this feast is actually Feast of Freedom. We celebrate freedom when people of Israel came out of Egypt. We all know this beautiful biblical story, and there is many chapters dedicated to this story in the book of Exodus, but people of Israel came to Egypt, and it was plan of salvation for the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jacob, Joseph, his 12 sons came to the Egypt, and it was amazing time. Egypt was a beautiful and blessed time. And by the way, important to remember that people of Israel, they had long time, a few generations of blessed time in Egypt. But also Egypt, it was place of birth of a nation, because Israelites came to Egypt as a 70 people and get out of Egypt 400 years later with a million people. So Egypt, it was the place of the, some people call it womb of the Israel, when Israel were born as a nation. Praise the Lord. So remember, many good things happened to Israel in Egypt. That was a wonderful time. But then new era came, new generation came, and Egyptians, they make Israelis slaves. Not in one day, but little by little, little by little. And that's a good message for us, because sometimes that's the way enemy of Israel, enemy of your life, taking our lives. If devil himself come against you to attack you, you know it's a devil, you know what to do, you know how to pray. But many times that's what enemy do. He doing step at a time, until suddenly you can find yourself in spiritual slavery. And that's what happened to people of Israel. But it was the beginning of greatest miracles in the history of Israel, in the history of humanity, because God visited His people in Egypt. And He started a beautiful process of redemption. Beautiful process, God saying to people of Israel, Ani kaniti otchem, I have bought you, I have purchased you, I have paid price for you. Now you are mine, says the Lord. So when we're going to celebrate Exodus from Egypt, Passover, we're going to speak about Jesus, what Yeshua have done for us, because Jesus, He was prophetic part of the Passover in Egypt. And all the story of Exodus actually pointed toward Jesus. So we're going to see biblical meaning. We're going to study about modern traditions, and many of them actually very old, 2,000 years old and even more. And we can see even how Jesus have celebrated Passover. Yes, Jesus have celebrated Passover. He have celebrated with His disciples at the last night, traditional Passover, and He make a new covenant on this day. Hallelujah. So it's a beautiful story, and it's a first feast. God gave the people of Israel 7 feasts, and now we're speaking about very first biblical feast. Praise the Lord. That's a glorious time. So we're celebrating freedom of people of God, redemption of people of God, redemption from slavery. Hallelujah. And the way God led people of Israel to the freedom. And this feast still carry the message for us today. speaking about our freedom through Jesus, through the Lamb of God. As a lamb, they were sacrificed. Many lambs were sacrificed in Egypt by families of Israel. But we have perfect lamb who was sacrificed for us.